Vickle Pickle has asked, how can you tune without a dyno? Is road testing a reliable and effective method even though you can't measure torque or advance with the other computer? Great question, and I will deal with this because I've kind of touched on it already. Yes, definitely it is not, the dyno is the best place to achieve our tuning. There's no doubt about that, and everything you've just said is correct. We don't get torque output from our car when we're out on the road, so it's really difficult to know when our ignition timing is optimized. What we'll find though, particularly if we're tuning on pump fuel, and definitely if we're tuning turbocharged cars that run on pump fuel, what we'll find is that when we're optimizing or tuning the ignition tables, we'll find that probably in greater than 75% of cases, we'll actually end up having the engine begin to suffer from knock or detonation before we reach MBT timing. And I refer to this type of engine as being knock limited. Now, in that situation, it really doesn't matter if we're tuning on the road or we're tuning on the dyno. We can't reach MBT, and that knock threshold becomes our limit for how much timing we can add. And in fact, we actually need to retard the timing a little way from that knock threshold just to give us a safety buffer and make sure the engine isn't going to suffer from knock out on the road or the racetrack. So with this sort of engine, if it is knock limited, that knock threshold becomes our limit, so we can essentially get almost identical results on the road to what we can achieve on the dyno. Now, of course, that's not to say that's always the case. There are engines that aren't knock limited. Those get a little bit more tricky to tune on the road. We also may be tuning on a really high quality fuel, maybe E85 or a specially blended race fuel. And in this case, we do have some problems. In this case, if you've got no option but to tune on the road, you're better off being a little conservative with your ignition timing and accepting the fact that you may be leaving a little bit of power on the table. Now, another way that a lot of our customers around the world use our road tuning additions is that for them, their time is relatively speaking free and fuel is pretty cheap. So what they'll do is take their car out, maybe on their weekends, maybe after work, and spend some time getting their tune pretty close out on the road. And then once their tune is really, really close, what they can do is hire some dyno time and just put the finishing touches there, optimize their ignition tables and get everything absolutely perfect. Now, another aspect that's also worth mentioning here is even with access to a modern high-quality chassis dyno like we've got here from Mainline, once I've completed the tune on the dyno, I still like to take the car out on the road or track and confirm that everything I saw on the dyno is correct out in the real world. Now, the reason for this is it's really difficult, even with a professionally built dyno cell, to replicate the kind of airflow, temperatures, pressures, etc., that we're going to see at maybe 120 mile an hour out on the road. So we don't race or drive our cars on dynos, so really what we're actually interested in is making sure that our tune is correct in the real world, in those real world conditions. So that's where our road tuning additions come in. They'll show you the techniques you can use to get the best results there.
That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.